What is going on, YouTube Nation? This is Dark Dividend. If you guys are new to my YouTube channel, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss future videos. So I have three cheap stocks for you guys to check out. These are all bank stocks. Two of them you guys requested. They're less than $20, and they are very popular bank stocks that people are loading up on right now. I did a little bit of digging and research on these companies. I'll do a little bit of an in-depth review on some of these companies, and I'll tell you which one I like best. So if you're new to this channel, again, you got to hit that notification bell after you subscribe. We are almost at 9,000 Dividend Warriors strong in this channel. Looking forward to getting to 10,000 subscribers and 10,000 Dividend Warriors. So make sure you hit that notification bell after you subscribe. I am pumping videos out like crazy, and I'm going to start doing some speed runs on some days that I can try to squeeze in. But I did promise you guys I would post a video today. So make sure you smash that like button, and let's check these stocks out right now. The first Dividend stock I want to go over is OceanFirst Financial Corp. It's sitting at 19.13. Previous close was 19.60. Its day range is $19.19.47. Year range was 18.30 to 24.25. Market cap 1.14 billion US dollars. Volume is 301.61K. PE ratio is 11.46. Dividend yield is 3.55%. And we will do a quick review on these guys. These guys are located in New Jersey, Pennsylvania, Maryland, New York, and Massachusetts. So, you know, the thing is, I mean, they're kind of on the East Coast, obviously. And the thing about bank stocks, I always tell you guys, is, you know, they make money. They make money on loans, car loans, credit card, interest. Anytime you swipe your credit card, they make money. So they, you know, stores have to pay a fee. I'll give you an example. There's a place like very locally where I shop at, and for years you can only pay in cash. And I didn't want to go there, and many people didn't want to go there, and they had to adapt. So they had to use credit cards because people were using credit cards and nobody ever carries any cash anymore. So they were hit hard. And then guess what? They became a store that accepted credit cards, more and more people came in, and now I go to that store because it's very convenient. So the thing is with banks, remember, I always say take it to the bank. They learned their lesson in 2008, 2009, 2007 when the recession hit. They were passing pretty much loans out like candy, and it caught up with them. Now they're a little bit more careful. So I'll go over their revenue and their dividend history. Okay, so here's the revenue. 2015, this is in millions US dollars, 102, 2016, 153, 2017, 215, 2018, 311, 2019, 350, 2020, 453, and then 2021, 394. So from 2015 to 2021, a huge increase in revenue, which is attractive, and banks make money. You have to be really stupid to go out of business. Either you're sucked up by another bank, or you're just a terrible business and you have terrible business policies. And it's either those two. That's what happens with some of these small banks. But in the long run, these guys are pretty big, and they usually don't like being acquired. Now, don't quote me on that. This is not financial advice for entertainment purposes only. Disclaimer in the description. But regional banks, small banks, they love customers. They love tradition. They love to make money. So that's one thing about these bank stocks. And let's jump to their dividend history. So 2010, they were 12 cents. And then they're still 2011, 2012, 12 cents. 14, 15, they were 13 cents. 2016, they cracked 15 cents. 2018, they cracked 17 cents. 2021, they cracked 44 cents. That looks like that was a special dividend. They're at 17 cents. Now, this isn't a really fast dividend growth stock. In the past 5 years, the dividend growth was 3.21%. The number of dividend increases in the last 5 years is one. Payout ratio is 36%. And if you bought one share, it was 68 cents with a 3.55% dividend yield. Now, it's not the best dividend growth stock, but you're going to get some nice dividend income. And I'm also going to show you their stock split history. It's a small stock split history. Don't expect these guys to split their stock anytime soon, but they do have a stock split history. In 98, they were 2-for-1. In 2002, they were 3-for-2. These guys are rebounding pretty well, and Hopefully, again, this is not financial advice for entertainment purposes, only disclaimer in the description, they will hike their dividend, and their trends are a little bit slower, but their revenue is doing pretty well. So, you know, that's one thing to take into consideration with this regional bank. They're going to be a little bit slow at first, and then they're going to start blowing up like crazy, because that's what happened with KeyBank. KeyBank was a little slow with their dividend hikes. They started to get bigger. They started to expand more, and boom, their dividend hikes were a little bit faster. Again, don't quote me on that, but that's what happens with regional banks versus like juggernaut banks like JPM. I mean, they're not going to be JP Morgan or any stocks like that. Let's jump to the next dividend stock. Here's another one, Hope Bancorp, sitting at 13.88, a dividend yield of 4.03%, PE ratio 7.66, volume 874.61K, the market cap is $1.67 billion. Day range is 12.48 to 17.68, its day range is 13.79 to 14.10, and its previous close was 14.17. So where are these guys located? And by the way, look at how they've done against the S&P, not very hot, makes these guys an attractive dividend stock. Let's check these guys out. The Hope Bancorp is a holding company of Bank of Hope and the first only super regional Korean American bank in the US with $17.8 billion in total assets as of March 31st, 2022, headquartered in LA and serving a multi-ethnic population customers across the nation. Bank of Hope operates 54 service branches in Cali, Washington, Texas, Illinois, New York, New Jersey, Virginia, Alabama, and Georgia. The bank also operates SBA loan production offices in Seattle, Denver, Dallas, Atlanta, Portland, Oregon, New York City, Northern California, and Houston. Commercial loan production offices in Northern California and Seattle, residential mortgage loan production offices in California, and a representative office in Seoul, Korea. Bank of Hope specializes in core business banking products for small and medium-sized businesses, with an emphasis in commercial real estate and commercial lending, SBA lending, and international trade financing. Bank of Hope is a California chartered bank, and its deposits are insured by the FDIC to the extent provided by law. Bank of Hope is an equal opportunity lender. So already they look more attractive than OCFC. Let's check out their revenue and their dividend history. So check this out. This is in millions US dollars. 357, 2015, 2016, 473, 2017, 638, 2018, 710, 2019, 734, 2020, the pandemic hit, 652, and 2021, 610. So I know there's a little ifs, you know, with the economy right now, but from 2015 to 2021, 357 to 610, and they occupy a lot of states, which is very attractive. And what's more attractive is their dividend history. So let's start in 2016. They were 11 cents, then they cracked 12 cents, then they cracked 13 cents in 2017. Then 2014, they cracked 14 cents. So they're sticking at 14 cents right now. And so thing is, the dividend growth isn't very attractive in the past 5 years at 2.15%. Number of dividend increases in the last 5 years is 2. The payout ratio is 31%. So if you bought one share, it was 56 cents, but the dividend yield is 4.03%. So this is a pretty good dividend stock, a cheap bank stock for you guys to check out. Let's jump to the final dividend stock. This is the dividend stock I've been loading up on. Heritage Commerce Corp, HTBK is a symbol. Dividend yield 4.79%, PE ratio 13.37, volume 180.88K, market cap $655.77. Year range was 1056 to 1294. Its day range was 1077 to 1102. And its previous close was 1105. I saved this one best for last because I like this one a lot. I'm loading up on this one. I just want to show you two dividend stocks that were a little bit cheaper out there. But this one I really like the best of the three. So I'll show you why. Based in the heart of Silicon Valley, Heritage Commerce Corp is a parent company of Heritage Bank of Commerce, established in 94. Heritage Bank of Commerce, with offices in San Jose, Danville, Fremont, Gilroy, Hollister, Livermore, Los Altos, Los Gatos, Morgan Hill, Palo Alto, Pleasant Town, Redwood City, San Fran, San Mateo, San Rafael, Sunnyvale, and Walnut Creek, offers a full array of businesses and personal banking services and products to the communities they serve. So let's jump to the revenue and the dividend history. So check these guys out. 2015, it was 87.72. This is millions US dollars. 2016, 106.56. 2017 116.52, 2018 139, 2019 152, 2020 160.39, 2021 162.94. Let's jump to the dividend history. Let's start in 2016, it was 9 cents, 2017 it was 10 cents, 2018 it was 11 cents, then 2019 it was 12 cents, then 2020 13 cents, then 2021 13 cents, so it's still at 13 cents, has a dividend yield of 4.79%, annualized dividend growth in 5 years of 6.42%, number of dividend increases in the last 5 years is 3, and the payout ratio is 63%. I'm not too worried. These guys are a bank stock. They're making money. I just like the way things are looking with these guys. And I like this one of the three dividend stocks that are cheap, bank stocks. I like these guys the best. And I'm loading up in these guys. I'm hoping to get to 200 to 400 shares and then reinvesting in dividends and letting it fly from there. So if you're new to this channel, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss future videos. This is Dark Dividend. You guys have a good one.